Hello, and welcome back to part, crap, 8, I think, of Goliath. And I'm back in the castle, all thoroughly re-equipped. I have bow. My sword now has Smite 2 and Breaking 1, which means when amplified with the Strength Potion, it can one-shot skeletons and zombies. I've also brought a regen potion with me, although I will not use it until I'm sort of at the focus. And I should... My sounds are back up from when I was doing other things. So this should enable me to one-shot zombies and skeletons. And I have the regen potion for if I can tell an area is about to get a bit frantic. Yep, one shot. Not a fan of hidden spawners, personally. Oh well. And the spiders will still be two shots, obviously. Because they're not affected by smite. Okay, that was a bit weird. Oh! Wow. Ouch. Also, I have a lot of baked potatoes, as you might have noticed. And I... Okay. So, turns out those were dispensers, not spawners. Not a whole lot of a threat since there weren't any mobs, though. Yeah, I don't want all these. Let's just... make sure they can't be triggered again by putting blocks in front of them. Okay, so that could have been really dangerous if there were a lot of mobs in the area, but there weren't, so it wasn't. Okay. Creeper spawners. Oh, that's a threat. Okay. Do I want... Yeah, that kind of debilitates my ability to make a good grinder since I can't... Have I mentioned that I can't tell the difference between trapped chests and non-trapped chests? Is that even trapped, or is it it's like a block update, or what caused that? Is that one trapped? It's rail supplies. Neat. This looks like something new. I'd say that this is an intersection. I found intersection 1 5 minutes into the episode. The Red Desert, the deserted ruins, the rattling caves. I'd like to find the monument. That would be neat. Oh well. Wonder if there's anything down there. Yep, there is. Bet it's a record or something. And by rec, I've been watching as used to playing Pantheon, so I think of records as the bonus items. By record, I mean emerald. Well, triggered a trap but survived. That's neat. Okay, just tunnel around this way. Yep, emerald. Emerald 8. Have I missed 3 emeralds? That's ridiculous. Well, there was the ender chest up there. Okay, I only missed 2 emeralds. 6 and 7. But still. So I'll just take a peek into each area. See what's up. Wow. I still have time, lots of time left on my Okay, water. Interesting. That doesn't really give me a whole lot of information of what to make of this area. But oh well. Don't want to go much deeper than that, since there looks to be a lot of threats. The rattling cave. Yeah, I have no idea. The deserted ruins. I'm betting there will be a lot of loot chests in here. Ah, an open air area. Neat. I get the feeling that there's... Oh yeah, I prefer exploring open air areas to... when they're open world to cave areas. Simply because if it's a cave area, you have to thoroughly light up everything, and it's just generally hard to deal with. I like my caves, okay, my buffs are wearing off. I like my caves and other such things to be fairly linear. Red sand. A lot of red sandstone. Ah, fine. I hope you're not... Okay then. They just tried to kill me. With creepers. Where did those even come from? Okay. Is my voice still audible? Yes. Alright, strength's not on anymore. I don't have any armor anymore. Intriguing. And another wide open area. Okay. Are they connected? They seem to be connected. Huh, that's unusual. Well, they tried to kill me, and even though I didn't have any armor with creepers, and even though I didn't have any armor on, they failed. I have all the cactus I could ever want, it seems. And I still have 10 minutes of episode to fill out. I could. Ooh, I have access to sand, which means access to both sandstone and glass in terms of resources. Ooh, enchanted armor leather. Well, now I'm wearing clothes again. I really need a new microphone. Okay, it stopped. And it did not stop recording my voice, it sounds like. The playback in my ears isn't all that loud, so I have to really lean in order to be able to tell for certain whether it's still active. But I now have access to sand and wood in terms of materials, and there's no obvious entrance. Yeah, if I was playing the map on hardcore, I'd have had trouble a long time ago. And you're guaranteed, what seems like it was supposed to be a guaranteed death didn't actually kill me. Or what the flavor text seems. Be back in a moment. Oh, sorry about that. Yeah. I get phone calls every now and then. It happens. Why did I do this? That was incredibly foolish. I know better than to just jump down into a group of mobs. But oh well. Enchanted wood tools. Interesting. Yeah. They don't really rival what I have, I don't think. I don't think efficiency one pick it beats out stone. Is there anything underneath? Some spawners. Yeah, I think I'm at the bottom. So, night's falling. I'll probably want to use some beds for this area. Because it's so large, that way I can sort of... A, reset my spawn, and B, be able to set it to day at will. Can't imagine there would be a... they'd build a pyramid. Pyramids are like the standard find stuff here places. Ooh, that one looks important. But, you know, maybe not. Anyways, I'm going to go back into the caves. And... might try to get a base set up at intersection 2. This is intersection 2! I've already beaten intersection 1, I guess. It's kind of surprising to have an area there that doesn't have any wall in it, but... So, except it'll take me a long time to set up a base, and I'd like to just sort of have it at the beginning of the episode. That'd be much better. Maybe I'll poke into Valor Cave, see what's in there. And by Valor Caves, I mean Rattling Caves. I've had enough of Valor by now. I have proven that I'm valorous enough. Next episode, I might search for Emerald 6 and 7. Make sure I haven't, say, missed any particularly obvious sub-areas in Valor Passage. Next episode, I think, will be my... Oh dear. I've made a mistake. Yeah, next episode I will, I guess, make sure I didn't miss any large sections of Valor Passage and try to find the walls, if the emeralds, if possible. But I believe this is where the map is going to start getting rather hard because of the wide open explorable areas. The Red Sands and that other place. Okay. Lot of water here. General good advice about water and maps, stay out of it. Stay along the banks and fight the monsters in it as necessary, but don't let yourself get in it. Yourself? Don't get in the water. Unless you're on fire. Don't fight for extended times while in the water. Oh, no. You're never equipped to deal with a witch. That took unnervingly long to kill. I seem to have gotten a potion of health from it. That's a chest. I'd like to get that chest. There are a lot of creepers in my way. It could be trapped, and I'll have no way of knowing until I hear hissing or whatever. And Okay, time to retreat. Cool, a bow. Again. Don't want to use my regen potion if I don't have to. And considering this is just the beginning of the area, I ideally shouldn't have to. I'll call that chest my episode objective because we're at about 20 minutes now, I think. Although I didn't pause during the phone call. I didn't pause my timer, that is. Might be a good place for a skeleton grinder, since there seems to be rather a lot of the spawners. Oh yes, that's exactly what I wanted to put there. Precisely. You saw right through me. Awesome! So, I guess I'll call that an episode. I made it to intersection 2. I've done a quick look at all the areas. Oh, 2.5-ish. There are 3 areas with it being an intersection at all, and I've So, you know what I was saying about not fighting in water? I just fought in water. I fell for pretty much every trap, but none of them killed me. So that's neat. And I gathered some stuff out of... Oh my gosh, all that leather armor I gathered is almost dead already. This is why I don't like leather. Although I could anvil it, potentially. Who's a shooting? There you are. And I do have the new golden chest plate, which won't last all that long, even though it does have unbreaking too. But I'll figure out what to do with respect to a base, since I now have sand. I'll probably mess around with Aha! I was right. I was hoping it's not a trapped chest. Since I now have access to sand, I'll probably mess around with... Well, there's nowhere the trap could really go, so I'm going to assume that it's not. Food! Awesome! Even though I have plenty of potatoes. Oh, and there's some water right next to my base area, so I can actually make it convenient to get to farm now. But sand means I can mess around with glass, which will be nice. Since this is a sandstone area, I'll probably base in... I'll have to mess around with colors, decide whether I want to do sandstone or like some sort of smooth sandstone, or if I want to do wood. But off camera, I'll spend plenty of time moving stuff from there to here. Maybe come up with some sort of shortcut, rail line, etc., etc. And look for potential places where I might have missed an emerald. Although, my experience thus far tells me that emeralds are never really going to be fun to hunt for. But in any case, that's the end of this episode. See you in the episode that will follow this episode. Ah. Crap. I don't need a tripwire hook. Why do I want a tripwire hook ever? Yeah, bye. Hi, I'm Master Wonder Mage, and welcome to episode 9, I think, of, whatever this is called. I found this combat kit, but this will sort of be an episode in pieces, while I get everything set up and hunt for emeralds. I found a combat kit up here, just some basic, a full set of leather armor, which I'll probably use to repair this in a little while. But I saw a light, I'm thinking most likely an emerald. So, I'm currently heading over there to try and get it. A lot of the emerald huntings, that could have killed me. Yeah, still at 5 deaths. A lot of the emeralds seem to be hidden in places where you have to kind of dig around a bit to get to them, and hunting for them seems to be largely looking for any holes in the wall that are there, or in that one place, in Grove of the Burning Oaks. I had to, by the way, I'm still making the trip back. I haven't made a trip back to my original base from Intersection 2 yet. So, I'm still have a bunch of the random junk in my inventory. Haven't decided what I'm going to do for the house yet, although I will probably have the house built by the end of this episode. This episode, unlike most of my other episodes thus far, will not be filmed all at once. There will be cuts, there might be significant lapses of time between me recording, sort of depending on how things go. With any luck, I might splurge and buy a new microphone. Yeah, I think I will want to get a new microphone. Preferably one with not quite so long a cord, so I don't have to worry about tripping over it or anything. Yep, there's an emerald here. Emerald 7. So the emerald 6 is presumably before here, although... what's it called? The emerald 3 and 4 were not ordered the way you would expect. With emerald 4 coming earlier in the area than Emerald 3 was. I also blocked up that lava to see if there was anything behind there. There wasn't. And there's a witch over there. I'm not sure where to look for Emerald 6. I don't see any particularly suspicious locations. There you are. I don't like witches. I mean, it's nice in that they are pretty much the only mob that provides the late game threat. But in the early game, they're just a pain. Don't see anything that looks like an emerald place, although I'll have to look in more depth. I might have very well missed third. I might very well have missed an emerald in Ember Mines. I'll have to check that as well. The emeralds are. So yeah, I'm back at my base. I'll be ferrying supplies over. And over from one intersection to the other. And I'll work out what I want to do for a house and get back to you at that point. Missing Emerald 6. I'll also probably sneak a peek into Emerald or Ember Mines, see if I can find any likely emerald locations there. I think I only found the one under the gravel there, so yeah. I'll sneak a peek in there, and if I see anything, I'll investigate on camera.